In this quick tip, we're going to take a look at Adobe Firefly, in particular, the Recolor Vectors option. So let's turn it on, and there we need to upload an SVG. So let's take a look at how to prepare that in Illustrator. Let's take a look at the first file, which is this one. And in order to export this as an SVG, you go to File, Export, Export for Screens. And there you check out the SVG option, like so. The artboard has a name, which is kind of important, so you don't end up with artboard 1, artboard 2, SVG, and you can tell them apart in your system. So let's go here, and this is the folder, choose it, export the artboard, like so. There we've got the SVG folder, and then let's check out this SVG file. Now I'm going to zoom in here, and you see this is actually pretty exact. No, it's not. You see, there's a gap, and that's happening because SVG is not always exact. We're going to solve this in a minute. On top of that, you see this is an RGB file. It used to be CMYK, but it's now RGB because that's all that SVG can do. So when exporting SVG, you'll always convert it to RGB, which also means when editing it in Adobe Firefly, you might end up with colors that cannot be printed, and Adobe Firefly will not notify you of that. You will need to keep that in mind. Let's first close this and take a look at where to change the precision settings. So let's go to export again and export for screens, and then go on the cogwheel. There it is. There's the SVG, and there you check the decimal setting and set that as high as possible. So let's check out 9 and then go to save this, and let's go here again. So it's reset to 5 because this is Illustrator 2021, and in higher versions you can set higher settings for the decimal. So let's leave it as this, and let's export it again and replace the other artboard. So 5 might not be sufficient for this one, but that's all we can have. Of course, it would help in this situation if these weren't, you know, sliced up. So it's better to use the Pathfinder first to unite all of them. Let's go to Firefly and use this. So go to Upload SVG, and then go to the SVG where you saved it. So in here, there's the toucan, and upload it. And then you can input whatever you want. So let's have some jungle vibes with parrots, green, and let's just generate that like so. And you see, there are the results of this, and in here, for example, we've got some greens that most probably could not be printed. So next thing is you can go in here and check out those options, just what has been prepared there. And I like these. You can also go in here and then shuffle them to spread them out differently across the drawing. And you see, it works a bit like recolor artwork because the same colors are colorized in the same way. And then you can download this like so. It goes into your download folder. And you can also rate it, and then, of course, enter different keywords. The next thing is you can change the color harmony, and There you can also use complementary and get brighter colors with a strong contrast in it. And you can also set up some colors you want to use in this by just selecting them down there and get the results, but then you should get away from complementary and maybe select the triad to get all or a lot of your colors into it, like so. So you can also preserve black and white in order to keep black objects. Most of the time you might want to do that. So this is how that works. Now let's take a look at some different things in here. So I'm going to check out a different file, and you see this one, and there are issues with it. You see those red colors are not exactly the same. They should be, but they aren't. So we're going to take a look at what Firefly does with them, and I have already prepared that because it's somewhat striking. So when you look at this here, then you see that differently colored stroke here gets a wildly different recolored version in here as well. So this one is better, but in here it's different as well. So when using it, you might really want to check your colors first so you don't get these results. When you use recolor artwork, then Illustrator can group those colors better, but Firefly cannot do that. So you end up with these different results. You can, of course, use that for your purposes. So let's go in here again and let's upload a different SVG in here. And I have prepared another one, this one, which is kind of a bright logo, which has way too many colors in it. And let's see what it generates here. And this is kind of nice tropical feeling in here, or maybe that one. And you see those bright colors are somewhat adjusted to that. They are really wildly bright. We can also look at that file in Illustrator, so you see the original, and let's see it here. So, like so, this is the original file, really, really brightly colored. Let's also check out the result we generated. So let's open this here, and there we have the first recolored result, and you can open that SVG in Illustrator. And then, of course, it's still an RGB file, and if you need CMYK, then you have to, of course, convert the color mode back. And you see the color changed here, and of course you need to correct the black because it's now very muddy. You have to edit that later on in order to adjust it to your CMYK mode that you might need with your file. So this is how you can use Firefly for inspiration for your logo files and your other vector illustrations.